So I will ask the viewer to look on and do some detective work in your own mind as to the shapes and symbols you see. Here we can see the owl. We're revisiting the clock we saw earlier in Parliament. Now we are going to Belconnen. You may need to pause the video at times, by the way, as I'm not going to dwell on all the detail. So a guardian spirit or totem looking over its domain. In reference to the owl here, a guardian spirit. Here we are at Moore Street, looking at a planetary installation on the roof there. We're now looking across to the radio station, ABC Canberra, and looking down onto the octagonal roof. The National Museum of Australia with the blue marker there, and we can see a lightning strike type structure there. There's Australia in the middle with that red spike coming from the centre. Just looking at some conceptual art here, album covers. Back to the design. There's a spiral at the side. A reference here in the Phoenix. An interesting skylight also on the building. We now go to the R.G. Casey building. This is beside Parliament House. Looking here at the Jachin and Boaz pillars. And now we're looking at the pillars regarding the Kabbalah. Mercy and severity, with the middle pillar here, perhaps seen on the ground running through the middle of that building complex. And I'm trying to put it all together here. The pyramids, perhaps. Here we go. So Anzac Square, Brisbane. And again, the Kabbalah. Here it's more obvious, looking down Anzac Square, and I'm drawing it out. Some just continued shots. London, America.
So here we are in the Queen Victoria Building. And if we look below, you can see the beautiful tiled floor with the design. The Kabbalah. With the Star of David.
Cockington Green, Canberra. There are miniature buildings here. That's a maze, Stonehenge. Miniature, of course. We're on Black Mountain now. Just looking at a model of it. It's perhaps phallic in nature, with the female component being the rings going up it. John the Baptist Church, just off Anzac Parade. Looking at the phallic steeple, and again, if we look at take a close look at the cross, and that's quite interesting. Very interesting. This light fixture. A gargoyle actually has water coming out of its mouth because it gargles. Interesting. So there's the vaginal doorway, of which we're about to enter. We'll have a look at the interesting designs on some of the windows in the church. Yeah, we can see the St. George cross in the Star of David there, with the sun's rays. An interesting tribute to Herbert Verewitz, President of the United Nations. The light's very poor in this church. The Royal Australian Air Force Memorial, highly phallic. Look at the base. When we see the base, we look at that water reference, the female water, reminding us immediately of the Australian-American Memorial. This statue is titled War, or it's known as Belladonna. Belladonna is the Roman goddess of war. This plate or shield has a very interesting design on it. The battlefields there, made by Bertram McKennell. It's a bit wet that day. Yeah. We can see the Air Force Memorial in the background there, and now we will pan around to another very interesting memorial. The Sandakan Memorial by Anne Ferguson. This memorial is actually a sundial. Okay. A tribute to a major battle in the Second World War, the combination of the Australian and British Commonwealth forces, World War II in Japan. Just having a look at this memorial. There we go, panning around, that's the Australian War Memorial. A phallic object there. Okay, the Australian Hellenic Memorial. We're just off Anzac Parade now. And let's have a look at some of the detail here. Please note the overall design. There's a crimson rosella. Okay, so we'll just have a look at this sort of V-type shape emanating from the centre, better seen from this height, with the metal piece at the top, sort of a plan of Greece, or a map of Greece on the floor. This is the Kemal Atatürk Memorial, commemorating post-World War I relations between
Turkey and Australia.
There is the five-pointed star there with the moon shape in the middle. The trees surrounding also relate to the sculpture. The pines.
Here is a memorial to the woman who served and suffered in defence of Australia. And if we look a little closer, we see the curve, representing the curve of a woman, with the waters. The water being a female element. So the sculpture to the Australian woman in war is just over here. And if I just pan around, I have the male counterpart here to all Australian service people who have served, but this one is predominantly male. Very phallic look to it.
The grove of birch trees relates to the memorial also. Here is a memorial relating to the Magna Carta, one of the foundations of the current legal system. The wall behind relates to sedimentary levels in the earth. I think this installation sculpture relates to the sun, as you can see in the ceiling with the four divisions going off, reminding us of natural law, I would hope. There's an aerial view. We're now in the old Parliament House buildings. We've moved away from the Anzac Memorial. We are now in the what's known as the Parliamentary Triangle. The red roses perhaps relate to life, whereas the white relate to death, as per the tarot cards, perhaps. We are located, you will see the yellow triangle. That's our location there within the Parliamentary Triangle, as per that map. This is the old Parliament House that we are outside. A sculpture by Rainer Hoff, the Aboriginal tent embassy sits outside the front of this building, being the old Parliament House. Here is the Australian coat of arms and the English on each side. Now we see the St. George and St. Andrew's crosses. This is the inside in the King's Hall of Old Parliament House. Now we're looking at the square design, 3x3, relating to Saturn, the magic square of Saturn. And looking at the floor, as per the ceiling. Here we are looking around, and there it is there in the pavement, outside the front and around to the side. And now we're looking further at just the general grounds there, interesting designs. In the gardens surrounding Old Parliament House, we're back inside, now going into the House of Representatives. The decor in here relates to the earlier decor in England, and the Parliament House there, the green. Detail, Liberty, still shot. We're now in the Senate chamber, the red decor, still shot. We now go to the National Gallery of Australia. This is an installation on the outside by James Turrell. Notice the pyramidal design. He makes other sculptures that, not all of his sculptures have that pyramidal shape, but the one in Canberra does. Some information there, it's called Within Without. So we're going now, we're inside, now we're walking right into the middle, into the sky space. That is a moonstone, or it's called the moonstone. Floor, and we're looking up through during the dawn and at sunrise you get various colours in this room. Now we're just going to look at some other sculptures in the sculpture garden surrounding the National Gallery of Australia. This is interesting, the angel from the north, one of five. Here is a spherical planetary type sculpture. This is an interesting sculpture outside the National Gallery. That sculpture again. And now in this shot here, I noticed something in the sky. I can't identify it, so it's unidentified, yes. It's flying, yes. And it's an object. I don't know what it is, but it's there, and it leads us to where we are going now. So, looking down onto the Academy of Science, known as the Shine Dome, this has also been explained as a saucer looking, like a flying saucer. It has that kind of look to it. An interesting looking building. And now we head to Red Hill. Here we see another interesting looking building at the summit. That's where we are. It's a restaurant at the moment. And there it is. And we can look down onto Parliament House. And there's an historical shot.